So hello everyone, my name is Simharava and I'm based in Berlin. And this is actually the shrine room of the new women's community that we founded just a few months ago here in Berlin. So my situation is that I live here with another 5 women and we just managed to move into this place in February, and so we finished to set up stuff just before the lockdown came. So personally, I've been in a very positive situation to live with friends here in a very beautiful place, a little bit outside the city in Berlin. And so in general, I mean, our lockdown hasn't been as strict as in other parts of the world. And now we're also in a process of transitioning to a new phase where we will also reopen our Buddhist center next week. So we're just trying to figure out how life will be with the coronavirus and some kind of normality, however that might look like. So for me, Bodhicitta is actually very much connected with the figure of Avalokiteshvara, who is my Yidam, and so I meditate on this figure every day. And Avalokiteshvara holds the jewel very close to his heart, and this jewel is a symbol of the Bodhicitta. So it's the symbol for the heart wish to gain awakening and alleviate suffering in the world by showing others this path to enlightenment. And what I find deeply inspiring about Avalokiteshvara is that he actually listens to the suffering in the world. So he's taking in the suffering, and at the same time he's radiating rainbow light and gives compassion. So I have been asking myself, what does that mean for me? How can I take in suffering and give compassion, especially in a situation like now? Personally, I mean, I live under quite positive conditions with people that I love, and so I know that there's a lot of suffering in the world out there, but it is not very much part of my daily experience. So I mean, I know that people suffering from isolation, people suffering from fear, people suffering from all sorts of restrictions, but it is not so much part of my experience, which doesn't mean that there isn't any suffering. And I think for me, one thing that is a practice is to see and to take in the suffering of the people that I live with. And every human being experiences some kind of suffering. And living with 5 women in this community, I mean, there is a constant opportunity to kind of trying to be open and see the suffering that they experience. And at the same time, I think I found out that what I can do is to alleviate suffering in the situation not in a direct but an indirect way. So my partner actually decided to go back to working as a doctor when the corona crisis started. And so he's working in palliative care with people who are dying and who are very much confronted with sickness, with death, and all those restrictions and isolation. So I think he's in touch with a lot of suffering. And what I found was that what I can do is somehow support him and be a good friend to him, so that he is able to meet that suffering in the world. So on another level, I thought, okay, what can I do in that situation? And I think I thought I want to share something of what is most valuable to myself. And so I started to record some Dharma texts and some traditional recitations and put them online for people to listen to on my SoundCloud account. And I found that to be quite inspiring and just a way to contribute something and to radiate something of the Dharma in these conditions where people are not able to come to the center and to meet people and to meet the Dharma face to face, at least I think the voice can carry something of the Dharma, which I find really inspiring. So another question that I ask myself is, how can I strengthen my resolve, the wish to practice for the benefit of all beings? And so in my sadhana practice, in my daily meditation, I recite those verses, the Bodhicitta verses, and they go like this. For the sake of all beings, equal in the skies, who have been my mother, I will gain unsurpassable awakening. And they're beautiful lines. And so I usually try to imagine all sorts of people and imagine them as my parents. And that's quite challenging in a way, because they're also difficult people and people I've probably don't connect very easily with. But I think it's a very good imaginative exercise in order to kind of extend my wish and to practice that and not exclude anyone from that resolve. But the bodhicitta, the wish to gain awakening for the benefit of all beings, is much more than that. It is not only the resolve and the practice on the conventional level of experience, it's also the deathless, the elixir. It's something that goes absolutely beyond our imagination. And I wonder, how can I contact that level of the bodhicitta? So what inspires me deeply is Avalokiteshvara's connection with sound. So it is him who's listening to the cries of the world. He's taking in the suffering. He's trembling with the suffering of people. His heart is resonating. And it's not only the suffering, it's every kind of human emotion that sets his heart into resonance. And I mean, I really love the idea that the Buddhas communicate enlightenment through sound and through vibrations in the universe. This is something I find really inspiring, and I think we can actually train our bodies to become more receptive to sound. And I've been using a lot of free time over the last weeks to do body work and voice training, and for me that is a really inspiring way in order to become more receptive to train my body as an instrument that can be open to be touched by something from a different dimension somehow. And what I find particularly interesting with sound is that it is, as a metaphor, a great way to go beyond the notion of self. Because at the end, there's just sound, they're just vibrations, and it doesn't seem to matter who's the creator of the vibrations, who is resonating, or who's being touched by the vibrations. So there just seem to be a field of vibrations. Bhante always stressed that the bodhicitta is more likely to arise in the spiritual community practicing together. And I think the metaphor of sound makes that very tangible for me, because we can open our hearts to each other and resonate with the vibrations of the deepest longing, the deepest heart wish in us to gain awakening and alleviate the suffering in the world. And sometimes this may create something very magical, a glimpse of the elixir, the nectar of the deathless. I recently took part in an online meditation retreat on Avalokiteshvara and was absolutely fascinated to see that we don't need to come together physically. It can already be enough to meet online to spark off that resonance. And I really wish that it is the bodhicitta that unites us as a community.